in Middlemount, where the table-topping Tigers take on the Clermont Bears. Pertec women's competition, the ball is kicked deep, and it'll be picked up by Baxter Schloffler to Candice McKee, who brings the ball forward. Mitchie Hewitt, back as we said, I think it's one of the first games of 2017, and she's straight into the action. Stokes then works it, turns it inside to Anderson, and Anderson is put to ground Charlie Robinson, who makes the tackle on Anderson pretty solidly, beams in a dummy half. A name we haven't heard of in the Central Highlands this year, but obviously he was a player last year. So Beams goes back right side McKee, and Candice McKee will be brought to ground by Charlie Robinson now, 42 metres outside the arc on the western side of the field. Stokes on the fourth, 45 metres out, looks a little downfield. It's Brownstone to Ed Arnie McCabe. He's finally regathered the ball, 15 metres outside the line. So she'll bring the ball forward for the Tigers, ladies. First minute gone in this round one clash, and the score is nil all. So as they play the ball, the winger is Zoe Bridgman. She's new to the team, only had a couple of games for the Tigers, ladies. It's a good score for her. She plays up front. Watkins in a dummy half, then works it one off the right. Jade Belville with the ball. And he's brought to ground by Carly Bell for the Clermont Bears. So on the fourth tackle now, Watkins working at right side, no for Ross. The last game, of course, we go to the Emerald Star Hotel. The match in that game because she was outstanding, scored 2 tries. We didn't get to call it, unfortunately, in the Giro Shield game between the Sam Wood clubs, but outstanding. So Maria Weary now has got the ball. She's seen the throw of the dummy, and it looks like, I'd say that there was an obstruction in there. Which is the referee, I think they said there was an obstruction in there. And the lights there still be gambled. So first penalty of the game after 2 minutes of the. What I like to see is they kick the trap from you. Pop that one. Stokes has got the ball now, turns it left side. Centre ground, Candice McKee is. First ball tapping opportunity here for the Bears. They're 25 metres away. Beams left side, Bell. Bell taking the line on, trying to step around, but it's Weary and Mitchell Hewitt who make the tackle on the Bears. So they work the left side again, the eastern side. Rogers takes it on, throws the dummy, gets it away. Rolf has been hit by Bridgman, but she regathers the ball. And she is just over the try line. Has she scored? The referee is saying time is up, and it's held up. And it was a good piece of play there. Tegan Rolf, I thought she lost the ball, but she was able to regather it in time, and she's been held up. So some good defense from the Tigers there.
Yeah, awesome.
So Kayla Rogers now with the ball, turns it inside. Carly Bell now. Seems to break away 1 and 2, and she's just over the line as well, but I think she's going to be held just short of the goal line. Here we are, nil on the scoreboard. Beams dummy half goes to Rogers. Rogers kicks it up high, and it's taken in goal. Bridgman, and it looks like she's gone dead. And I was wondering what Luke Daly was signaling there. I think he had a little bit of a brain fade for a sec. She did take it in the in goal area, so up to the 24 inch start score. Cooper Hill with the ball, straightens up finally, she ran all the sideways, but she finally straightens up. Watkins then works one off the ruck again. Last game for her, I think it was the man of the match performance, the player of the match performance in the grand final, but I've given her the commentator's curse. She's lost the football, it's gone both ways, but a struggle we've had towards the Clermont Bears, ladies, 35 metres out from their own line.
Yeah.
Blanche Abel. Slater get out of the back of the scrum. Rogers now takes the line on, looks to throw the dummy. She's able to bust off Maria Luru, opposite 5'8 tonight. She's finally puts it around. That's Maddie Edmonds. She's going to have to bring it down to the side of Luru. So she'll play the ball 35 metres out. Mikulov now goes for a scoop from dummy half. She runs around the winger in Bridgman. She's still going down the Houston touchline. And she looks to finally surrender herself. She threw the ball out to nobody. And well, there was Mr. Nobody there, so it's had to be picked up by the Tigers. And the referee's restarted the tackle count for the tackle one. Picks up Watkins, the side goes Melville now with the ball, brings it forward. Still the ball on the scoreboard, 6 minutes score. And this referee, Watkins, left side, Lynn. And Nari Lynn now. Off the bench, in the action, all the Tigers ladies. They're going to bring it back centre field. That's line out the ball. Lovely ball into Robinson. Robinson still going. And is able to do a ball. Inside the Clermont Bears territory now, 32 metres out. Watkins left side. Why again taking the line on? Gets the ball away. Parter. And Beck Stokes going at it. Each other. It was a good tackle there from Stokes, who brings part of the ground. Lines tackle 30 metres out. It's Mawiri kicks it. It's been taken there, Beams. And Lindsay Beams will be brought to ground. Good set of six for the Tigers. It's been good footy played thus far. 7 minutes gone.
Yeah, great set of six for the Tigers. They made plenty of ground. Just to kick the ball a bit shy on being a long distance kick. And have just been a short kick.
And Caleb Rogers now is... That's Sarah Noon, he's got the football. She plays the ball. Beams then left side, turns it back inside Stokes to Anderson. It was a good tackle, Charlie Robinson. But she's come off second best there, unfortunately, at the moment. It looks to be a shoulder, and the time is pulled off. But, of course, we don't have time off.
Yeah, that was a great tackle by Stokes. She gave it pretty hard. And Anderson made it.
Shoulder, she grabbed the shoulder, a bit of magic, a bit of magic. Rogers, one off, gets it away to Mikulov. Mikulov then throws the dummy to go back inside. She gets sent off right away to the winger. The winger then charging down the Eastern touchline. They're passing it off again, another offload. It's offload central here in the middle of the paddock. About to venture past the 10-minute mark. Beams will go back inside to Rolf. Rolf just outside the Tigers 40 midline, boots it downfield. And Cade has gone to take the ball, but it's gone backwards. She'll finally pick it up and run around one of the Clermont Bears players. And she's finally brought to ground as Tegan Lowe. He's had to bring it to ground. 20 metres outside their own line, the Tigers are. Casey Watkins goes short side, and she goes herself as well. Usually, she's played a couple of times as well. Casey Watkins is brought to ground 30 metres outside. Riri goes acting half, then Melville on the left. They're just working the right side of the field. They're all on the scoreboard. 9 minutes gone here in the middle. As Watkins brings the left side. And it's in the hands now of Tiggerola. Third first game for the Titans. So they, the four tackle, Lye takes it on, gets it away to Rewiri. They're able to read the play in it. Mikulov who brings it again. Last tackle, just inside the Bears' territory. Watkins a dummy half. Goes to, in fact, runs it herself, kicks out a dummy half. It's not a bad kick. There's no urgency there for the Bears whatsoever. And Fry puts it on the boot and then picks it up finally. She'll run it to, into the Bears' defence, to the Tigers' defence, but a penalty's been blown. I thought there was an obstruction. The referee has agreed with me. I didn't say anything, though. Saw that, unfortunately, I think they were a little bit of, they got themselves tangled up a little bit there and took the opportunity away from the defender.
Yeah, well, she did a great job.
Tigers only having 16, so Charlie Robinson is receiving a little bit of attention at the moment. I think she's going to get a strap up, it looks like, with the FA College. Numbers for Tigers. It's going to be probably a long second half for them with only three on the bench.
Yeah, with the ladies, I think they need more than the regular.
Toby Watkins will kick the touch. And good kick as well. So it's really the Tigers' first opportunity attacking the Bears' line. They'll take the tack 15 metres outside of the Bears' line. Watkins takes the tack and slides in. And Murray Lee working the ball through. And he's tackled only 5 metres short of the Bears' line. Watkins looks to go right side. They're going to use Hewitt. Hewitt goes over. Can she score? No, I think she's going to be held up. Referee says yes, it was held up. Unfortunately, she fell with her back to the line, so there was about a 3-point defence around her, so there was no chance of her scoring. Here we are, just waiting. They've got a little bit premature. Good. Watkins gets it away live. Okay, line one off the rock. Watkins goes through this time. They give it Belville. Jade Belville going for the ball as well. Looks to go a skelf, scooting from dummy half. But again, the Bears' goal line defense. Holder short of the goal line. Fourth tackle. They go back to the short side. It's Lynn. They've rushed up on her. They get it away. Hill. Hill looks to throw the dummy. She runs back inside. She's found a space. Can she get the ball down? She does. And Cooper Hill will score first for the Tigers ladies here in Middlemount. After 14 minutes of play, it's the Tigers 4, leading the Clermont Bears 0. Kick to come.
Yeah, that was a good try by Cooper Hill.
So there, the Emerald Tigers, number 3, Cooper Hill, with a kick to come. Emerald Tigers, 4, Clermont Bears 0.
Seeing the
players
coming from the shoot, Dobbs step back inside, and unfortunately, this tackle there could have got her out of the line if that's a guy. No, Tigers are going to the ground.
If it falls over, there's a lot of
money. Keep them out somewhere. Of the next line so far, the Tigers, and a try.
That side of the length.
Just a little bit unfortunate, they're outnumbered there. They've got to particularly watch the edges just from an observation. And they've got to look at the edges because there was overlaps on either side of the field. They probably got a little bit too white line feverish in the first couple of tackles of the
six-nil.
The kick was successful by Danny Edmonds to make it 6 points to nil. 20 minutes to go.
Big pressure, especially when you know what's going on.
Yeah, only ladies match will be in action.
Not even
about the ladies where we see the girls down here with questions tomorrow. 2:30 in Hamilton. Last time these two teams, the first two teams met in Hamilton. Yep, semi-final, we had to get extra time.
Yeah,
your job's done early in the morning, then enjoy a beer and Rogers restarts his play. She kicked the ball. Party throws the dummy, she tries to run through him. We know she can be dangerous if she runs straight through him. She calls and makes a beautiful carry from Kenson, plays it quickly off his dummy half, then turns it back inside Ross. Ross then carry forward. That's all the time he's had so far, making some meters, and they've worked the ball about 45 meters. This is the last play. Weary's got it, kicks it 35 minutes out of the Tigers line. Great take there from the Belmont Bears. They're still working forward. I think it's through the end of the 16 Salah. Teague has got the ball at number 5, so Sharia was last check. Maybe plays quick, but we can all see. They're working through. Anderson now has got the football. They're rushing to play the top of the defense. They've certainly showed some urgency in this early part of the game. 6-0, 18 to go first half. Beams right side, turns it back inside Stokes. Stokes then gets it out to the western side, Bell. Bell's got numbers on the right, she throws the dummy though, but it's line. Last tackle. 30 minutes outside the Tigers. Line Beans straight to the field. Stokes has got the ball. She kicks it over the defensive line. Zoe Bridgman's got a hand to that. We'll see the referee's call. He says going backwards. No, he has it. He said knock on. So it'll be a scrum with the Clermont Bears to have a fresh set of six to attack the Tigers line. But it is the Tigers in the early 6-0 lead here at North Beach over the limit. The scrum, speaking of Carly Bell, she breaks and scores. Well, we just mentioned how good of a game she has, and she has just run up for Taylor Rogers, gets a lovely ball out to Carly Bell, and she just runs straight for a
wonderful ball. Well, there's number 13, Carly Bell, to Colonel Bears. Colonel Bears, 4, and the 5-6 with a kick to come.
Rogers away, but Bridgman makes a tackle, is outstanding, and forces it offload, which turns the ball over. Great tackle, Taylor Rogers. Great tackle, Zoe Bridgman. Even though that she's been a little bit slow, unfortunately, she hasn't been the best one. So the Tigers with the ball, the Shadisha ball. She's caught the ball, and she's tackled 45 metres outside, right behind their centre field. Watkins in, will go to the right. And there will be another flat bar in the box now for Quinton Moore. It's 6-all, 13.5 to go in the first half. Here in round 9 of the Queensland Women's Competition. They bring it back into Parter. Parter then, long cutout ball to Hill. Hill looks to run back inside. Oh! 40 metres outside of the Bears line, its last tackle. Rawiri's got it. Wasn't quite sure what she was going to do. You speak about it again, she kicks to the winger. It's Allison who comes out of the red basket, but it's gone backwards and she's finally brought down the table. 25 metres outside of their own line. That is Mikula who gets it away. Rogers is outside of her for some reason, but anyway, she's been on a step around 1 and 2. She gets a lovely offload out to Mikula. Mikula now straightens herself. Centre field takes the defensive line on, and a good one-on-one tackle. Casey Watkins bringing in the ground 45 metres out on her own line. Centre field beans, right side again, into the hands now of Nikita McDonald. Brought to ground. The two sisters tonight, McDonald and Hamsley. Looks for to see a bit of family love, and we'll see some family love later on with the playing. The ball was loosely thrown out the back there, and it's going into touch on the Western side of the field, so it's coming back. Time is to have the feed. 12 to go at 6 apiece. Trying to beat them all using her strength, and she scores. Using her strength, she's able to get over to try number 2, Carly Bell. And it looks to the lead 10-6. 10 to go first half.
Throw there, the front of the band, number 13, Carly Bell. Throw up there, 10, and we'll try your 6 with a kick to come.
Successful with
the final bear, number 6, Carly Rogers. Final bear is 12, and we'll try a 6 with about 8.5 minutes left in the the first half.
Tiger's defense. That's try 3 for Carly Bell. We might as well not call the
Clermont
Bears. Even the initial.
So number 3 and number 13 from the Clermont Bears, Carly Bell. Clermont Bears 16, Hamilton Tiger 6. We're about 6.5 minutes to go. Kick the cup.
Stokes throws the dummy, then gets it away to the hands of Lawrence.
Just to see his intuitive way.
Caleb Rogers is the first real kick that's going to test around.
there, you can think about 5 minutes next to the sideline, so we'll see how she can go with that. But as I said, the half starts the second half, like the first half finish, so they may continue on the same way, but the Tigers need to pick up their defence and tuck a few in Riley Charles.
Said this.
We
know Miranda Bartley
tonight, so. Yeah, Miranda played, we gave her a call early in the year for part of the match, and she enjoyed her $50 at the Emerald Star, the race was obviously player of the match. Lucky kid for 2 games a week in the Emerald.
Certainly. Do thank them very much. They've got their TAB open as well, so perfect. She got it on the legs. It does.
Just a couple. That's how it always starts. That's how it always starts.
We've got another game of footing. for that 2015 grand final.
This was the grand final.
We've got the Blueberry Panthers versus the Emerald Tigers.
20 meters, but they've knocked it on the
ground. They're down the footing.
Oh,
a few tackles over the last 5 minutes. So Rogers looking for players. Who's she going to link up with? Keegan Robb. But they've read it well, but they get the offload away. Numbers on the left. Carter ball out into the hands of Glenn Lawrence, who's playing at left centre. And she'll pick it back. Rogers going short side. And she's able to bust through the line. And she'll score, Kayla Rogers. She deserves a try tonight. And she beats, I think it's poor Maddie Edmonds again.
Right there, and we'll play my pairs. Number 6, Carla Rogers.
Ladies, to make it 28 points.
Play my pairs. Play my pairs, 28. And we'll target is 12 points. 15.5 minutes left on the clock.
It's a good awareness, particularly from Kayla Rogers, who's playing on the left side, as he is the left-hand half. Open the eyes up and realise, we've got an overlap here, let's go. Cut out the ball, it was a good defensive effort, but they weren't able to slide quickly enough. We were 3-2, they were
Oh!
Let it bounce. Oh no! Jay Melville knocks it on. Not happy with the leader, and an appeal for the penalty. And I think he's picked it up. They touch it in front of her as well, so I'll get the penalty. Wouldn't be surprised if they have two. Safest option, I think, that amount of that. 15 seconds to go, 6 points in it. So just got to hold the ball here. Don't worry, you see last year's grand final is a juggle in the last couple of seconds of the game. 5 seconds remaining. Rogers will play 8 metres outside. Beams turns it inside. Rolf goes for it. That's all. Absolute thriller here at Middlemount. They've been given a treat to witness tonight. 30 points to 24. Bears win just. Well done to the Edinburgh Tigers. They certainly.